Hey there folks, welcome to Wall Street Investment Banking Tutorial, and today's topic is cash conversion cycle. So cash conversion cycle has everything to do with the amount which you have spent on buying raw material till the amount which is left in your hand after you have paid to the creditors. Alright, so it is a pretty simple formula, you know. So if you look at the particular screen which I've got here, it says that the cash conversion cycle of Ford vis-a-vis Amazon is this much. So Ford is running a cash conversion cycle of 261 days, and while on the other hand Amazon's cash conversion cycle is just 25 days. So you might be wondering what's happening with these two companies. Alright, so let's just look down and see what's happening here. So I would just come down to the formula here and I would just read it out. And the cash conversion cycle is days inventory outstanding plus days sales outstanding less the days payables outstanding. So understand it this way. So the amount of money which you have paid to buy the raw materials has, you know, you have invested that money there, buy raw materials so that you can produce the goods which you need to sell. So once the good is produced, you have the inventory in hand. So once the inventory in hand is there, you will sell it to someone on a credit, right? And once that happens, you know, the debtor, the person whom you have sold it to, will give you money after some time, and then from that money you would pay to the creditors if you might have taken the raw material in on credit initially. So after doing that, you would be left with some money, and you know, that is the overall money which you are left with, and the amount of time it takes, you know, from when you started investing in the raw material till the time you have the money in hand is just cash conversion cycle. So let us look at the formula here again, and it says that cash conversion cycle is days inventory outstanding plus days sales outstanding less the payables outstanding. So when it talks about inventory outstanding, it just mentions about the inventory days. And again, the same thing is with receivables days and payable days. So typically what we calculated for the balance sheet is just given here, and the addition of inventory days and receivables days and the deduction of payable days from there. So how would you calculate the inventory days? Inventory days is very simple. The overall inventory which is there in hand by the cost of sales, or rather the COGS, times the 365. 365 is the number of days in a year. And the same thing would go for the days payable outstanding. So days payable outstanding and inventory, you consider the COGS. While for days sales outstanding, you consider the sales or the revenue, all right? So here in the next section we have got the day sales outstanding. So day sales outstanding is accounts receivable, the amount of sales which you have made on credit by the accounts receivable by the net credit sales, all right, into 365. And then again, days payable outstanding, so accounts payable, the amount which you have to pay to the creditors from whom you have taken the raw material, times 365. So this is going to be the formula for days payable outstanding, and the addition of inventory days and receivable days and the deduction of payable days from that would give you the cash conversion cycle. So let us try and look at on an Excel sheet. So days, or let's just say inventory days, receivable days, and payable days. So CCR is going to be CCC, cash conversion cycle, is going to be, well, let me just spread it out for you. So CCC is going to be inventory days plus receivable days less payable days. Yeah, so this is going to be your formula. So now inventory days, how would you calculate inventory days? Inventory days is equal to inventory by COGS times 365. So this is going to be the formula for inventory days. In the same way, receivable days is going to be the overall amount of accounts receivable by the credit sales which you made. So sales or revenue, let's just keep it sales, times 365. Again, payable days is going to be accounts payable by COGS times 365. So this is going to be the whole equation. So the value for COGS is going to be what? The value for COGS is going to be less gross profit. So this is going to be the equation for COGS, in case it is not given, but it is generally given as cost of goods sold in the financial statements. So let's just take a look at the numbers for our companies here. So let's just take a look for Amazon. Alright, so let's go to Edgar. Type the company's name, Amazon, and search it. So Amazon, I think this is the one, Amazon.com. So now let us look at the 10K here. So Amazon.com, and if you look at the consolidated financial statement, you would see the, so this is the consolidated statement. So net sales figure is given, but you don't have the value for gross profit, and so we'll have to find it here somewhere. So in the assets you would get the value for, in the assets you would get the value for inventories. So inventory values is given here, right? And just have to look for the, so statement of operations, net sales, and then cost of sales. You see this? So net sales and cost of sales is given, alright, and you can just calculate the values from here. So cost of sales for 15, 16 and 17 is given. So let's pick up the value for cost of sales. So cost of sales is COGS is this much, and net sales is product sales and service sales. Net sales is this much, and we're assuming that this, the sale is credit sales, right? And what else we need here? We need the value for inventory. Accounts payable and accounts receivable, and these three values would be available in the balance sheet. So let's go down here and find the value for inventories is this much. Accounts payable is this much, so $34 billion worth of payment has to be made and accounts receivable, or rather receivables is, yeah, so accounts receivable and net and other. So this is going to be $13 billion worth of payment has to be received. So in this case, what is going to be the inventory days, right? So inventory days is just going to be inventory by COGS times 365. So this is 52.32 days, right? This is in days. I would call it days. Now, receivable days, I'll just copy it from here. Oh, let me just type it. It's going to be what? Receivable days is going to be accounts receivable by sales times 365. And this is again going to be in days. And these are the value for 2017, guys, okay? So please mind that. And then again, payable days. So payable days is going to be accounts payable by COGS times 365. So this is again going to be in days, okay? So the overall cash conversion cycle would be what? The overall cash conversion cycle would be inventory days plus receivable days minus payable days. So the negative figure denotes that the company is not paying for its inventory, and this is a very desirable situation to be in, and you would not find with this kind of thing with many companies. And if you find this, it's a very good thing, it's a desirable thing. So that means the company is buying everything on credit, and the creditors are letting the company, you know, run without demanding money for a very long period of time. And as the company receives money from the from its customers, it just pays the creditors back. So that's what's happening here, and that's why a negative CCC can be seen here. All right, so I hope you've enjoyed, you know, this particular video, and you can read more about this on the website here, you know, and bye for now and have fun.